Hey guys, how y'all doing? Time to bring some focus to your favorite and not so favorite geeky films. Cam here, and welcome back to Cam in Focus. Before we get started, be sure to smack that subscribe button so you can stay up to date with geeky news and discussions. Geek News Now takes pride in being a reliable source of media news so that we don't keep getting hounded by clickbait. So hit that subscribe button and follow us on social media to join our family. And just as a reminder before we get started, head on over to rippedapparel.com and use the code GNN10 at checkout. That code will get you 10% off of everything in the store except their daily shirts. But I mean, come on, look at everything else they've got. They've got some awesome stuff in there, dude. Head on over to Ripped Apparel and see what they've got in store. Link in the description below. And don't forget to use the code GNN10 at checkout.
Do it!
Here we go. Oh man, they just don't make these kinds of films anymore. Alien is one of those classics that many have watched, but fewer and fewer these days truly appreciate. For its time, it was a groundbreaking film about the crew of a freight ship called the Nostromo slowly getting picked off one by one by an unstoppable alien monster. This film influenced science fiction cinema in so many ways. It's hard to find a science fiction film that doesn't share some kind of similarity to Alien in one way or another.
What is the name of that imitator? Who gave him permission to pretend to be Hercules?
But I gotta say, while the alien, called a xenomorph, is terrifying in its own right, the design of which was created by the great H.R. Giger, it's not what makes the film so terrifying.
What?!
This is a monster movie that doesn't have much of the monster in it, and I think that truly works to this film's benefit. In a lot of cases, less is more. First off, the atmosphere of this film is absolutely chilling. The cinematography is very close and dense, switching between grand wides and uncomfortable close-ups where you can see every individual bead of sweat on the faces of the characters. The set designers really do a great job of making the Nostromo feel simultaneously functional as well as lived in for a long time. While the technology of the film might feel dated and very, well, 70s, I find that it has a certain charm to it that seems to create its own unique aesthetic that doesn't distract you with super flashy tech that's just there to look pretty. Yeah, I just wanted to rant about that for a second. On to the main topic. In horror films, there are these magical things called suspense and tension. Yeah, I know, two things that most horror films these days wish they had. The main driving force of suspense is a lack of control, which is something every single character in this film can relate to. Suspense is more than just a quiet few minutes where someone's walking through an empty house waiting for a jump scare. The problem with jump scares, especially fake ones, do nothing but remove any tension a scene could have had, like the popping of a balloon. Even good jump scares, and trust me, there are plenty, act as a kind of segue between anticipation and relief. A good film can build a feeling of unsettling dread through its atmosphere, and Alien does that marvelously. Yeah, the xenomorph is scary, but the fear goes deeper than that. We're following a crew of basically unremarkable people who are beset by a force that they have no knowledge or control over. There's no big exposition dump where they call an expert who just happens to know everything there is to know about what they're up against. I'm looking at you, almost every paranormal film in the last 18 years. This film builds tension by allowing us to know and understand just as much as they do. And how much do they know?
Jack and sh**. Jack left town.
This film carries an overwhelming atmosphere of claustrophobic isolation, which I love about films like this, as well as an air of mystery. You don't find out what the creature truly is or why its eggs were on a desolate planet in the ruins of a downed spaceship, and that's something this film does so well. The not knowing is so much scarier than having every plot point laid out for you, because what could be worse than your own imagination? I feel like the unknown is just so much scarier than simply having to fight off something chasing you. It's a lot scarier to not be able to see what's chasing you than it is to know exactly what you're running from. Now, in preparation for this video, I watched the film, as I always do. The director's cut, of course. I hadn't seen this film in a very long time, and I was quite surprised to notice that you only see the xenomorph on screen for literally about 2 or 3 minutes out of the entire runtime. Most people these days will watch the film and be like, "What? That was so lame! Why would they make a monster movie with hardly any monster in it? Worst movie ever!" Yeah, it's true that you don't see much of the alien, but you always feel its presence. You can see in the characters' eyes the dread and the uncertainty and the fear. everything the characters do, they do either because of or in preparation for the alien. The few chances that they have to slow down and breathe are interlaced with this underlying sense of hopelessness that truly just oozes off the screen. When you do see the creature, and trust me, you do, the filmmakers make sure that what little you see sticks with you. Often, we're shown only just enough to get a basic idea of what this creature looks like, leaving our brains to fill in the gaps. When a filmmaker can make a creature that you barely see any of feel like it's in every scene, that's something to be proud of. Now, the last thing I want to add on here is that part of what makes this film so unique is its lack of a true main protagonist, which I feel kind of adds to the tension because as it goes on, it feels like not everyone is safe, which of course they aren't. Every character is unique in their own way without feeling like caricatures or archetypes, and while Ripley, played by the great Sigourney Weaver, does end up being the last one alive and go on to helm the next few films, she feels very much like just another member of the Nostromo's crew until the end, and I think that's part of what makes her character so endearing. In fact, for the first half of the movie, she doesn't even really do very much until shit hits the fan. To have an unremarkable main character be almost literally in the same boat as everybody else getting axed off, I feel like was the right move for them to make.
Speaking in English! Dickhead!
This film really sticks with me. Between the visuals, the performances, the editing, everything just feels so right for this type of movie. And it was great for a while until it wasn't, but that's a topic I'll get into another time. I hope you've enjoyed my little rant about what I feel like makes aliens so scary and so terrifying. This has been Cam in Focus, proud to be part of the Geek News Now Network. Find us on Facebook, Twitch, and Twitter, links in the description below. And don't forget to stop by Ripped Apparel and use the code GNN10 at checkout for 10% off. Have a wonderful day, everybody.